H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So what we will do is that I'll go to Google and show you ASCII characters table. Now, if you see the table of ASCII characters out here, okay, let's compare. Now, what is the value of G? G value is nothing but, let me define it out here. The value of G, the G variable is of integer format, and the value of G is 10. Fine, that's not a problem. Now, there's a plus sign. Should this be used as a concatenation operator or a addition? Here it is used as an addition. Why? Now let us look the value of H. The H is nothing but a variable which is of character data type. What is the value of the H variable? 2. And let us look at the ASCII character value of 2. This is the ASCII, this is the decimal character, and the ASCII value of 2 is 50. So this is your 2 as the decimal, 2. So the, sorry, the character 2. So this is, so we have declared the value of H as a character data type. And the value of the character data type variable age is 2. So let us look at the ASCII table. This is the character column. So let us look at 2. So where is 2? This is the character column. Let us look at the character 2. And now what is the equivalent decimal value in the ASCII table? It is 50. So that means if I go back to my Eclipse, what it is doing, this 50 is nothing but the decimal value of character 2. If you go back to your ASCII table, this is your character 2 for the variable H, and the converted decimal value for the character variable H, that is 2, is equal to 50. So that is what it is taking out here. So the value of the character 2 in the ASCII table is 50. 10 plus 50 is equal to 60. And that is why the console is showing you 60. Like this, what I can do is, I can show you one more example to understand the meaning of it. So I'll declare the integer, let's say, next example. Let's say I take k is equal to 100. Okay, I declare a character variable L, which is should be within double single quotes. And let's say I declare @ as the character value. Character value, that is, this is the value of the character variable or character data type variable. Now I put an integer M and I add up the variable K plus L. And I do a CISO. Okay, so the variable J, this is not J, this is M, is M. So what is the value that I basically get? Now what is the value of K? 100. The character L is having the value of @. Now let us go to the ASCII table. What is the decimal equivalent of character @? It should be somewhere here only. @. So what is the decimal equivalent of it? 64. So I go back and I add 64 to 100. What is the resultant value? 164. And that is what I should get when this println command gets executed in the console. So if I save the class file and run it, this is what I get, 164. Similarly, moving ahead with character, let's say I declare a double variable n equal to, let's say, 10. The declaration of the double variable can be in decimal or non-decimal format. Okay, I declare a char character O equal to, within double single quotes, I define, let's say, exclamation mark. And I declare an integer P which is equal to N plus O. Will the compiler accept it? The compiler will not accept it because this is in double format. This is in character format. How can you add? You can only concatenate a double format with the character format. Definitely the ASCII value will be taken into consideration. But the problem is that integer P is of integer data type. It can only hold data. A value declaration should be of integer type only. That means non-decimal or non-double format, whatever it is. So this is in double format. This is in character format. That is why the compiler does not accept this. But the same thing, let's say I add up N plus O. I put it to a variable called double. Double variable, let's say I put it as Q. Okay, this will be accepted because what is going to happen now? What is the value of N? 10. What is the ASCII value of O? Sorry, exclamation mark. If I go back to my ASCII table, I'll get it. It is 33. Okay. So what will be added? 33 will be added. And this will be 43. But result in the console eclipse will be show you at in decimal format. So it will be result will be thrown as result would be thrown as 43.0. So if I use a sysout and I just copy this part out here in the parenthesis of the println command, I'll just declare value of variable Q is Q. So what value should I get? I should get the value of 43.0. I'll put some more dots. Let us run the class file. I'm getting this. Okay, so that's about your character data type variables. The next thing that I want to declare or discuss today is Boolean data type. Now, Boolean data type can only have, Boolean data type variables can only have two kinds of values, either true or false. So you can write down Boolean data type variables can only hold two values, and that is your true or false. No other values can be declared for a Boolean data type variable. Okay, so let's put it as part of our note. So how do I declare the Boolean variable? So you have to use the Boolean keyword with a lowercase b. So B-O-O-L-E-A-N. So let's say I declare a variable R as a Boolean data type variable. Now what is the value that it can hold? Only true or false, that's all. So it can be true. Okay, now if I use a scissor to print out the value of variable r, I'll get the value of true only. So value of variable r is r. If I save the class file and get the value of r, I will see true. Similarly, the other value that a Boolean variable can hold is false. If you see out here, this is also a reserved keyword, that is why it is in red color. These values are also reserved keywords, that is why it is in red color, because that means that these values can be only used for Boolean data type variables. That's what it means. It cannot be used for any other purpose. Now if I do a println of this particular variable, so I'll get the value of the variable rs. This is s. So what is the value that I'll get if I run the classify after saving it? I'll get the value of false. So that's how it is. Okay. Now if I try to give any other value to a Boolean variable, let's say I declare a variable as t equal to 10. That is not going to be accepted because the compiler will tell you that type mismatch, cannot convert from integer to Boolean. That is what it is going to show. Cannot convert from integer to Boolean. Okay, that is what it is going to show. Similarly, if I put a variable as Boolean, let's say the variable is u, and the value of it within single quotes, let's say 1, it will not be accepted. It will say that cannot convert from character to Boolean. Similarly, I declare a variable, let's say uv rather, equal to within double quotes, that means string format. This is in your string format. Let's say hi. What is the syntax error shown? Cannot convert from string to Boolean. So Boolean can only accept value which is either true or false. That's all. Okay. Similarly, I can declare a variable w which is equal to, let's say, 10.0. 10.0 means it's in double format. So what is the syntax message? Error message. Cannot convert from double to Boolean. Okay, now the question arises is that if there can be only two values of Boolean, that is true and false, where is, that means you will have a question in your mind, that means the limitation of a Boolean variable is too much. Okay, then what is the usage of declaring a Boolean variable? Now, the usage of a Boolean data type is very much important as far as comparative operators are concerned, or the usage of the conditional statements is concerned, or the use of loop statements are concerned. In all these three scenarios, whether it is a comparative operator or it is a conditional statement that you are using, conditional statement, for example, if or else, or you are using a loop statement like your for loop or your while loop, the usage of Boolean is very much prevalent and important in these kind of scenarios. So we are going to see the usage of Boolean data type when we are going to see the concepts of your comparative operators, or the concept of your loop statements, or the concept of your conditional statements. So that's about it. That is what I wanted to discuss on this particular video. So coming back to it, if you have any questions, please revert to us. Thank you for watching this video. Thanks for the patience. See you in the next video.